Each one of us has a story to share. We are the protagonists of our lives, the hero or heroine dealing with the circumstances, unwanted situations, and realities of this world. I happen to have one such story too. This story is about a girl who was born in a society where women, unfortunately, get treated as a commodity, where they're judged by the clothes they wear, the structure of their bodies, and most importantly, by the color of their skin. And it didn't take long for this girl to fall victim to her own skin color. Everything was normal till the day she started school to witness the first ugliest reality, discrimination on the basis of complexion. In her coloring class, her teacher gave her a peach crayon, calling it a skin color crayon, to color the face she drew, while this girl chose a dark brown color. Everything around her was so white, was so fair, be it the cartoon character she used to watch on TV, be it the fairy tales or the bedtime stories she used to read or listen to, or the Barbie dolls she used to play with. Even the Disney princesses, all girls, start their childhood with. As time passed, she began to realize that despite all her capabilities, she was always judged on the basis of her skin color by those around her. She had no friends because nobody wanted to play or be seen with her. She never got a chance to become a fairy in her school place because fairies are supposed to be fair-skinned. When she was in grade 2 at a convent school, it was the first day of the session, and the religion teacher walked into the class and requested the non-Muslim girls to leave for their respective religion classes. And this girl, who was hardly 7 years old at that time, was also made to leave the class because the majority girls in those schools were Muslims, and the majority non-Muslim girls were dark-skinned, whereas the majority Muslim girls were fair-skinned. Like many other dark girls in her school, she suffered and faced a lot of criticism with terms like ugly duckling, blackie, hapshan, nazar battu, and whatnot. Even different songs were sung just to mock at her. She also remembers once being nominated in her high school awards ceremony for the category called Makeover Required, and the way her school fellows started clapping and hooting when her name was announced was not actually humorous, but hurtful for her. As she entered her teenage life, aunties and those older to her would recommend fairness creams to her. Beauty creams aside, she was told about all the possible desi remedies to turn herself into a fair-looking girl, with the fear of, who will marry you? How will you get a good job? One needs to look presentable to move in the society. Oh yes, being presentable in her society is directly linked with being fair-skinned. She spent her childhood and teenage life having zero confidence and low self-esteem. Thanks to the incidents she faced, a time actually came when she literally gave up and she didn't want to live anymore. But I suppose it wasn't her fault. It's actually how we have been brought up and taught at our schools and even at our homes. The fairer, the better. As well as our minds have been polluted by the unfair advertisements that are shown 24/7 on our television screens, as well as the cultural misunderstanding that being beautiful is all about having fair skin. We are accustomed to listening to stories from our elders, tales of Snow White, all nothing but discrimination against the darker skin tones and preaching colorism. What to talk about the mothers who are always in search of fair-skinned daughters-in-law for their sons and rejecting those who are dark-skinned. Luckily, color was never a topic of discussion for her family, but sadly, it was for the world outside her home. Being an antisocial person, she always preferred not to interact with people much, as the past incidents had a huge psychological impact on her and a dent on her self-esteem. But then she finally decided to join the world of activism to overcome all the fears that she've had. And with the passage of time, she became an active social player trying to bolster up the declining women on the very grassroots of her country. She not only had been working for the basic social rights of women with disabilities, but also those without disabilities. She also started working for women empowerment, and then with the passage of time, this girl started gaining confidence. But one thing was always there. Despite of all her hard work, despite all her efforts and achievement in the world of activism, the skin color stratification did not leave her. And she would still be mocked with such statements like, oh, let's paint her white. Sometimes she tried raising her voice against colorism, but her cry for something that affects millions of girls out there was met with a resonating silence. The question kept nagging her as to why the society rejects those who are dark-skinned, and why does the society follow an unrealistic definition of beauty, as complexion is something that comes from God and nobody can change it. I am that girl, and that was my story. I finally decided to take a stand against such biased attitudes and mindsets of our society and of our people, and to work for a cause that is much needed. I decided to dedicate my efforts for the much needed change that we all strive for in our society. And this is how Darkest Divine came into being. This is how Darkest Divine came into being, the first anti-colorism campaign from Pakistan working globally through a local action. A campaign that aims to transform Asia into a region where dark skin color is embraced with good grace as light skin color. This campaign also envisions a society where equal treatment is given to everyone, irrespective of their skin colors. And also it aims to redefine the so-called standards of beauty that our society has set. And also to redefine the negative connotation of word dark. Well, what basically Darkest Divine is trying to do is that we conduct different sessions regarding colorism, self-acceptance, and what also Darkest Divine is doing is trying to tone down the unfair advertisements and the messages they're trying to portray, that being beautiful is about having a fair skin. It also, basically, the unfair advertisements are also trying to convey a very negative message that the self-confidence and the success of a girl depends on the lightness of her skin color. Actually, coming up with an idea of an anti-colorism campaign was not a piece of cake for me. And I faced a lot of opposition. I even remember my friends telling me that, come on, are you crazy? How can dark be divine? And you know, such comments were given to me and I was being criticized. But then I started off with this campaign and I was hopeful. I started writing articles because I've also witnessed when dark-skinned girls apply for front desk jobs, they're always rejected. And they're told that they're a misfit for such jobs. And even if a dark-skinned girl does recruited for such a job, she is likely asked to apply a light foundation so that her actual complexion is not prominent at all. And when I say front desk jobs, I mean the positions of receptionist or flight attendants or TV anchors. I started writing articles regarding colorism and also started conducting different sessions so that people could have an idea about something that is ingrained in our society. We know about racism, but we don't know about colorism, although we have been practicing it since ages. So these are some of the sessions that we have been conducting, also in India, in Nepal as well, and in different schools and university. And finally, people started accepting the concept of dark as divine. And I want each one of you from this generation to support my cause, or at least take a stand against the unfair advertisements and the biased attitudes of people against the darker skin tones. If I could make it despite all the hurdles in my way, then so can you. I stand before you as an accomplished young dark lady whose journey started from low self-esteem and ended with pride and self-acceptance. I say it loud and proud, the dark is divine. Thank you.